lost the damn challenge, and that hurt my soul. We needed a tarp like a fat kid needs cake. We needed it. We wanted it. We were seconds away from winning, so it wasn't a horrible loss, but at the end of the day, it's a loss. No one ever remembers second place.
Kim. That's 4 votes Kim, 2 votes Sabrina. The winner of Survivor 1.
Anytime there's a blindside, it's pretty awesome. Just the look on somebody's face. I think Aaron wants to be here so bad that her getting blindsided would look really cool. I love seeing people cry when you crush their dreams. For the most part, I've written Aaron off. I mean, I haven't really talked to her one-on-one about anything. And she doesn't hang out with the tribe a lot. Plus, I think she'll be really, really upset when she gets voted off. And I'd like to see a freak out at tribal. I think that would be fun.
Aaron could be tonight. He doesn't have room.
Yeah. I think we might just hang out with Tyson.
We have to get rid of Tyson. And this might just be the chance to do it.
Ninth person voted out, the second member of our jury.
The winner of this show is on this mat.
All right.
I've loved this tribe since the day that we stepped on our mat. This tribe right here, we work for each other. We fight for each other. We love together. We do it with dirt on our hands, with blood on our hands, with sweat rolling down our faces, with tears in our eyes. And I'm telling you right now, whether he walks, I walk, she walks, he walks, someone on this tribe, on these stools, right here, is gonna win $1 million. Bottom line.
Mike, does it make you sit up a little taller when you hear Lindsay? Because that speech really does encapsulate one thing. We are all blue collar, and we all know what that means.
I will give Lindsay 100% credit. I think she unified us day one when she said, the winner of this game is on this tribe. It sparked big dreams in all of our hearts, which made us fight for each other.
The winner of Survivor, Mike.
I'll write your name again, and if I'm up there in the final three, you'll still give me the $1 million vote.
I'm honored that I get to write your name down again and give you $1 million. Love you.
She didn't do anything.
If they had an operating room challenge and I lost, I couldn't go back to my job.
Yeah. During surgeries, you have to hold like retractors or instrumentation, and you can't really move. If you move, somebody might get hurt.
Saree loses her concentration. Amanda wins final immunity and is guaranteed a spot at the final tribal council.
Nice looking fire, Mr. David.
I'm trying. Lucky not as good as Chris.
It's over. Chris has earned his way into the final three in a historic move, taking on Devin's.
Sit back up and say, don't read too much into this. Or you tell me to go vote, and we'll vote right now.
No, I mean, it wouldn't be. I'm good. No, let's vote. We're good. We're good.
Sophie wins final immunity!
Oh! No! How did Ozzy do so well?
Ty versus Ozzy. Two guys that seem very comfortable in trees. Very comfortable just hanging out on a post.
You know, Russell wanted me to give him a cross. We've talked about being Christians out here. He doesn't really want to bring that into the game, but I've kind of been very open with him about it and kind of forced Russell to talk about being a Christian man. And so he wanted to have a ceremony that solidified it.
With this cross, we can never lie to each other. So put it around your neck, you know that we cannot break this bond. In this game, we're out of this game.
Sounds good to me.
Coach.
I've got a perfect final three scenario. You, me, one other person. I'm giving you my word, dude, as a Christian man.
If you'll notice in this game, I'll say, hey, it would be great to take you to the final three. When I say as a Christian man, I promise you that this is what I'm going to do. That's an irrevocable promise. I want to take Ozzy to the end.
17th person voted out of Survivor South Pacific and the 9th and final member of our jury. Ozzy, need to bring your torch.
Well, the tribe has spoken. Try that again. They don't want you to go.
Yeah, right.
Time for you to go.
Get fire. As always, fire represents life in this game. You now have fire again. You are back in this game.
When I give you my word, my word's huge. Huge.
It's the most important thing to me
at my age. I don't have much, but I got that.
Nalee and Pascal, I think, are really supporting my success in this game and are really rooting for me. And knowing that you can rely upon those two people, I mean, it's like two free passes. It's an amazing experience. I mean, it's actually kind of mind-blowing.
I'm not going to go out fifth or sixth. We've worked too hard. We've been here for too long, worked too hard, and I'm not going to go out like that.
The 8th person voted out, first member of our jury, John. No need to read the last vote.
Basically, what you're asking me to do is trust in people that I've never met before. And
I have your back until the end. I have your back, and I will never put your name down. And I will fight for you. So it's just a matter of who you want to roll forward with, man.
Well, I'll tell you this, man. I trust you 100%, so I don't want to, like, make any hard sell to you because I don't think I have to. Obviously, I'm going to write down Adam's name. That's what I'm doing today. And if you vote Adam, it'll be a tie, and then I got to worry about making fire. Obviously, my fate rests entirely in your hands, but I just trust you. That's it.
We're good.
Yeah. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Seventeenth person voted out, and the 10th and final member of our jury, David.
Action, man! Action, Richard!
Yeah. Action! Well, you don't want to act ahead.
I'm good to go, survival-wise. People-wise, it'll be a little more challenging. But I've got the million-dollar check written already. I mean, I'm the winner. And it's that kind of cocky attitude that makes people really hate your guts. So that's the kind of thing I've really got to keep under wraps. But it's just, how do I get there from here?
The winner of the first Survivor competition is... Rich.
The whole reward couldn't have been better.
All beef.
All beef, Joe's all beef.
Mr. Joe is loading up on beef and beef and beef. Like, it was bad. And I knew from my personal experience that Mr. Joe wasn't gonna be in a good place later on.
I'm a little beat up today. I'm having some problems here with my stomach. And I ate all that meat yesterday. I'm bloated, and I'm not passing any urine. I'm in a little discomfort right now in my stomach. I'm hoping that what I have going on right now is not serious.
You are pulling Joe from the game.
I think with the potential risk of long-term kidney damage, it's the only safe thing to do.
Once you get the fire out, we're closer to the shelter at all. It's gonna be like a rainy day.
This rain is bad, man. The elements out here can really get you.
Are we gonna try to canopy it out again?
This morning we woke up and it looked like it was gonna rain. We all know that it's important that the fire at least stays going. So we moved like all of the chests around the fire to protect it from the rain. That's important.
I mean,
Gosh, I'd be the stupidest Survivor player taking Tony Leon.
Me too.
Most ridiculous.
15th person voted out, and the 9th and final member of our jury. Cass, need to bring me a torch?
Thank you, old man.
Woo. Stupid, stupid, stupid.